We invite FIEP Europe President Professor Branislav Antala from Comenius University of Bratislava to give an invited lecture.
Ladies and gentlemen, dear colleagues, dear friends, firstly I would like to thank for invitation. It is great honor and pleasure to have opportunity to be speaker in your 8th international conference organized by Faculty of Sport and Physical Education, University in Pristina, Kosovska Mitrovica, FIEP Serbia, Association Sport for All Serbia, Faculty of Physical Education and Sport, University of East Sarajevo, and Faculty of Physical Education and Sport, University of Banja Luka. Secondly, I would like to congratulate to organizing committee and especially to Professor Verobljuk Stankovic, President of Organizing Committee, for excellent, important job that you did with preparation and organization of this important international event. Topic of my presentation is selected indicators of quality physical education in opinions of high school students in Slovakia, Czech Republic and Croatia. I prepared this my presentation together with Dario Novak from Croatia, Jana Vašičková from Czech Republic and Iveta Cihová from Slovakia. As an introduction, I would like to mention that exist a lot of serious global problems in today's world who influence quality of life of people. For example, massive population growth in some parts of the world, gaps between rich and poor countries and people, lack of food and drinking water, but also corruption, unemployment, terrorism, drugs and non-communicable diseases. Today, these global problems are covered by other problems, and this is the coronavirus pandemic that is affecting lives of people around the world. Coronavirus pandemic is so intense that it overshadows another serious global problem, and this is sedentary lifestyles and physical inactivity of people. Just a few generations ago, physical activity was an integral part of daily life. Today, physical inactivity actually seems as something normal. Unfortunately, the corona crisis has brought future restrictions on physical activity and supports higher level of physical inactivity of people. Physical inactivity is a big problem with significant related health, economic and social consequences. Governments, physical education and sport organizations and federations, those working in the field of physical education, sport education and physical activity promotion are actively working towards more effective policies and actions, especially for children and young people. One example of adopted documents represents special Eurobarometer 472 with title Sport and Physical Activity adopted in 2018. Main findings from this document are: nearly half of Europeans never exercise or play sport, and the proportion has increased gradually in recent years. In given week, more than half of Europeans do not do any vigorous physical activity, and around half do not engage in moderate physical activity. 15% of Europeans do not walk for 10 minutes weekly, while 12% sit for more than 8.5 hours per day. Researchers working on the field of physical education are focused on different points of view to physical inactivity of children and youth, including researches focused on position of physical education as a school subject in school curricula. I would like to present one example of this kind of research with title attitudes of young generation to quality physical education that has been realized as a part of XPE Biennial research program. Research sample in this study was 1,357 students from secondary schools in age of 15 and 18 years old in Slovakia, Czech Republic and Croatia. As a basic research method was used questionnaire focused on five selected areas of quality physical education. Popularity, importance, demandingness and next selected indicators of quality physical education, social capital, new technologies in physical education teaching, health and healthy lifestyle, and inclusion in physical education. Student for answering used Likert scale from positive to negative answer. I would like to present you some selected result only in age of 18 to 19 years old, boys and girls from the sample. If we evaluate the popularity of the subject among students, we can see that physical education is still a very popular subject among boys in all monitored countries. However, it is less popular in girls, while in Slovakia and in the Czech Republic the popularity of subject among girls is slightly higher than in Croatia. If we evaluate physical education from the point of view of the perception of its importance as a school subject, we can state that physical education is perceived by pupils in all monitoring countries only as a subject with medium importance, while boys attach more importance to it than girls. In assessing social capital, we have chosen one question as an example. Do you feel students collaborate with each other in your high school? We can see that positive responses prevail in all countries and they are slightly more positive in boys than in girls. There is significant difference in the answer of girls from the point of view of the monitoring countries, while girls from Croatia are the most positive about this question. One example from the use of new technologies in physical education. Question was whether students use new technologies during physical education classes. Pupils' answer show that in all three countries, new technologies are not used enough in teaching of physical education. However, the results show that the situation is the best in Croatia in this respect. The answers to the question related to the perception of the importance of physical activity for health we can evaluate positively because they show that in all three countries, both boys and girls are aware of the significant impact of physical activity on their health. We did not find important differences in answer in evaluated countries. The last two questions are concerned to the inclusion in physical education. The answers to first of them show that most of students can accept students with disability in a physical education classes, but this is mostly the case of students from Croatia. The same results are to the answer concerning the possibility of using co-educational teaching in physical education, where the most positive answers were presented by boys and girls from Croatia. However, it must be said that the pupils' opinions on this question are relatively different, they are not split at all, and they are distributed over the whole range of answers. In the end of our presentation, we would like to say that answers collected by this research just before starting corona pandemic can be today influenced by new special situation related not easy position of physical education as a school subject in different level of schools in Slovakia, Czech Republic and Croatia, and also in other European countries. We believe that children and youth don't change their relatively positive attitudes to physical education, and maybe they understand today better during corona restriction its importance in school curriculum. We hope also that this not good situation with PE teaching during corona pandemic with many different restrictions will finish soon, a quality of physical education will come back soon in our schools. Thank you for your attention.
Poštovane i drage koleginice i kolege, dragi prijatelji, pri kraju ovog našeg skupa, koji je osmi po redu, kao što znate, u prilici sam da kažem nekoliko reći, a pre svega da iskažem svoju radost veliku, zbog toga što ovaj naš skup nije prekinuo onu divnu nit naših stručnih okupljanja. Također sam u prilici da iskažem svoju veliku radost zbog toga što ste vašim radovima i prisustvom na ovom skupu pokazali da se nismo predali. Vremena su izokrenuta, teška, ali vi ste pokazali da u vama tinja onaj plamičak koji osvetljava put kojim treba da idemo. Izabrali ste dobar put. Svojim radovima ste ugradili značajan kamičak u predivnu sliku naše struke, koja znanjima, kao što je to istaknuto u jednoj definiciji fizičke kulture, koja znanjima unutar svojih područja fizičkog vaspitanja, sporta i fizičke rekreacije, omogućava transformaciju ličnosti od stvarnog u moguće. Ističemo ovo čovjek i ličnost zbog toga što ste vi ličnosti koje ste pokazali da iz ljubavi prema vašim studentima i vašim đacima činite napor da svojim radovima ugradite taj kamičak u znanje naše struke. Ta znanja koja ste vi priložili na dar našoj struci preko ovog našeg skupa, ona će da svetle i da osvetljavaju put generacijama koje dolaze iza vas i koje će stremiti makar da dosegnu one visine do koje ste vi dosegli. Ličnost o kojoj govorimo i o kojoj se govori u našoj definiciji fizičke kulture, i ja potpuno sa pravom ističem i ovom prilikom, razlikuje se od individue, kao što znate. Razlikuje se jednog prostog razloga što individua je svesno odbacivši Boga kao oslonac, počela da luta u ovim teškim vremenima i teško će da ispliva na površinu. Ličnost kojoj vi pripadate i nadam se naši studenti i vaši đaci, ona će znanjima i iz naše struke biti sposobna da prevaziđe ove tegobe koje nam donosi ovo vreme, izokrenuto, naopačko vreme, i nadam se da ćemo svi zajedno dočekati onaj trenutak kada ćemo sa malim smeškom da govorimo o vremenu koje je iza nas, a koje pamtimo kao COVID vreme. Ovom prilikom želim da se svima vama zahvalim na trudu koji ste uložili pripremajući vaše dragocene radove i kojim svedočite o vremenu u kome živimo. Također želim da se zahvalim svim kolegama sa Fakulteta za sport i fizičko vaspitanje, naravno i dekanu profesoru Stankoviću, i da na kraju svima vama poželim u ime FIEP-a i u svoje lično ime da u životu koji je pred vama baštinite samo dobro, a nikako zlo, i da, ako Bog blagoslovi, Sljedeće godine se vidimo u ovo vreme, martovsko vreme, na kupalniku po deveti put. Hvala vam i Bog vas blagoslovio.